Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final call for passengers boarding flight X to Kolkata. Our boarding gates are now about to be closed.
Me! That's my flight! Excuse me. Do you mind if I go in first? Actually, my flight started boarding.
Sure, please go ahead.
Thank you. You saved my day. Thank you. I looked like a panicked student in an examination hall, trying to frantically complete my answers in the last moment. My head was a scrambled mess with too many things to do in too short amount of time. On top of it, the person in front of me was taking too long. This panic had now turned into anger. What is it that you are doing here? Are you printing a boarding pass or discussing the wedding plans with her? That day, I learned many lessons. Lesson number one, meditate more often. So I completed my check-in, rushed through the security gate, skipping long queues of unimpressed people, and finally made it to the boarding gate. Hello, Mr. Kejia. How are you doing?
I'm doing good.
You've been upgraded to business class. I felt like a girl had asked me out for a date. A girl who was both beautiful as well as rich. To an engineer who's used to eating mess food throughout his life. To a student who's made to share a small ugly room with two equally ugly roommates. This news was heaven. Business class! She gives me an annoying look and continues. We don't have time to update your boarding pass. Please be seated. Your seat number is A1. This brings me to the next lesson. Lesson number two. In life, whenever you feel that you are getting more than what you deserve, be cool about it. So I settled in. I knew, having never traveled in business class, I knew that the next 2.5 hours are going to be full of intense awkwardness and discomfort. My first moment was not far off. Hello, Mr. Kejia. Now see, this way of her addressing me startled me. See, I hail from a middle class background. I am not used to people calling me by my surnames. I am used to, hey macha, what are you doing there? Hey idiot, come here ra. So naturally, this way of her addressing me startled me. Mr. Kedia? Who's Mr. Kedia? Dad, are you here, Dad? Oh, you're talking to me, I'm so sorry. Actually, I'm not used to such niceness. Lesson number three. Never make a fool of your dad. So I settled in. 1 hour into the flight, she comes to me, and this time she offers me a unique piece of a contradictory equipment. A wet towel. So inside my head, I'm like, okay, this is a towel. It is used for wiping and it becomes wet after wiping, but it is already wet. What is its use case? No, thank you, I'm good. Lesson number four, learn more use cases of a towel. See, to me there are only two use cases, after bathing and after washing your hand. In both the cases, the towel becomes wet after usage. You don't seek a wet towel, do you? So I had now finally settled in. 1.5 hours into the journey, she comes back and offers me something to eat. Mr. Kejia, would you like to have something? Are they free? I mean, what are the options?
She again gives me an annoying look and goes back to get the food menu. This brings me to my next lesson. Lesson number 5. Always use the word complimentary and not free. So you say, are these complimentary? And not, are these free? So this continued. And after 2.5 hours of intense awkwardness and discomfort, we finally reached. Did I tell you, while I was getting down, I could overhear a conversation between a cabin crew and the passenger. I don't know, he was from the economy class and he seemed angry at them for some reason. How can you do this to me? I am a privileged member of this airlines. You said you will upgrade me to business class. One second, sir. Let me check, sir. Can I get your name? My name? Aman. Aman Kedia.
But Mr. Kedia, we already did upgrade you.
Without taking a look at any of them, I swiftly bowed away. Lesson number 6. Have a generic common surname.